Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and
the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, let us begin this Holy Eucharist, which means thanksgiving, with the confession of our own weakness, which has accompanied for our own life, but let us also, will of God, that we are men of perfect and always dependent of God's mercy. So let us prepare our hearts and confess together. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have persisted in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, my most gracious Lord. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary ever praying, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord of our life.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Receive our prayer.
prosperity. Holy Father, who by no merit of my own chose me for communion with the eternal priesthood of your Christ and for the ministry for your church, grant that I may be an ardent yet gentle preacher of the gospel and faithful steward of your mysteries. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thanksgiving and my heart's been ever there. Amen, I say to you, when you were younger, you used to dress yourself and go where you want it. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. He said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. And when he said this, he said to him, follow me. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus
Sisters and brothers, I will begin with two remarks this Gospel. The Gospel of John, which we heard, is an encounter of the risen Lord with seven of his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias. First remark, why the threefold question and commission of Jesus to Saint Peter? I will not comment the different names for the same content, meaning the pseudonyms which Jesus used. The threefold question of the Lord, Simon, son of John, you love me. The threefold answer of Peter, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. And the threefold commission of the Lord, feed my sheep. Peter was distressed because of the repetitions, because the threefold question and commission gave both the character of a quasi-juridical strong obligation. Maybe that Peter was aware of his own weakness. This threefold is analogous to three weaknesses which were necessary in the court to prove the truth. But for Peter, it was clear now, and that he understood, that his proclamation of the Gospel is only authentic if it is based on the love to Jesus. When a priest applies this Gospel on his own life, that means that he has always to reflect and justify if the last motivation of his proclamation is the love to Jesus. Brothers and sisters, I'm not sure that I have fulfilled constantly this condition in my priestly life. Second remark in this Gospel, Jesus predicted very solemnly this twofold amen, amen, Peter's future. I repeat this passage. When you grow old, you will stretch out your hands and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. He said this, signifying by what kind of death he would glorify God. When he said this, he said to him, follow me. No one of us knows the circumstances of his own death. Now the identity of a priest will be proof of the guilt, how he is able to behave in the last moments of his life. Suppose this, that this last moment can happen in full awareness. We know that many of the priests will die in some intensive station, and we don't know what happened in this place. This the man always a woman who awaits the death on this intensive station. But nobody can manage by himself this last moment of life. What he can do is pray to the Lord, grant us this last moment in awareness, that he receives us. So, for this gift, we need to pay more than what we do. I think for Padova it's not so important, the situation, because he's young. But for me, the way I think this last moment is very near. And therefore, I hope that the Lord grant this situation and he opens his arms to receive me. Dear sisters and brothers, that is my hobby. What follows is a speech. My priestly ordination was on the Saturday, 26, 1971, in Münster. In many countries of Western Europe, it was a time of crisis. The end of the 60s and the beginning of the 17th, the last century. It was a crisis of authority in the profound societies, but also a crisis in the church, also a crisis of authority. Inside the church was the reason that there were serious misinterpretations of the meaning of the Second Vatican Council. I remember there were many great seminaries are not adequate for formation of the humanities. Therefore, many communities, they formed smaller rooms, lost the seminar, went with the permission of the authority of their superiors in apartments to live their intensive religious life. But the opposite. It was a year or two, and then this family came back. Also, the same is to power of there were many difficulties in the start. Teachers, they were very young people, they were Catholic, but they are in their youth also together with other sects, and they were not Catholic. And I was asked to assist them for the sacraments. So I didn't finish this topic. Only I have to say that as a teacher and as a priest, I have many possibilities to serve others. And then after about 9 years, I went to our school, private, and also there was the same situation. As director and as teacher, the priest was in the church. But there, in the mountainside, so there were some families in some families. They often did not go to the parish priest and they came to the school director. Now I want to say, in 2006 I quitted the school service and made the pastoral community work in Freiburg and in March 2012, I came to the Philippines. Here I am now. The last 10 years as Salvatorian priest, I have spent here in the Philippines and more money as service in the East Asian mission that could fight our life. In Germany, I lived happily for 8 years in supportive communities. And the same happens here. When I came, I was received very open in the gay and female community. And that was the beginning. First, I became the apprentice of Father Hubert, the initiate. You know that Father Hubert celebrates not only his 25th anniversary of priest, but also his 20 years of staying and working here in the Philippines. And the apprenticeship of Father, my apprenticeship of Father Hubert, was very good. I learned especially how to behave here in the city, because I came from Europe and was not really prepared for this stay here. And it was very easy for me to find a home in the novitiate. Thank you so much for the mastership. And I think also the same thanks to, especially for the 30 years of the novices in Finland, because they were so extraordinary lives. And this consideration for me. Though I made many, many mistakes. I felt that sometimes it was too late. Then in March 2015, but the other is right hand here, superior quality here to my Lord. Serve as assistant. In Father Adam, I thank you so much for your endless patience and care for this whole heart healing. Because that is really a cross for the fathers more than for you. Since January 2015, on the age of Sister Violetta, I began the prison service. And that was for me also very important. Because what we hear practice in our house is important, and that was my first assignment and my first duty. But the care or the problem in prisoners, I learned many things from generally for my life. And I was very grateful for the Philippine brothers who accompanied me to make the homily there, because I didn't make it so. And so I was thankful for these brothers who went in the last years with me. Finally, I thank the brothers of this house for your consultations with me, because sometimes I have the impression that I am a little bit harsh with you. And I'm sorry that so is in certain situations. But I am really very grateful that we cooperate on the other part together. And the preparation of these feasts for Father Hubert and for me, you can see also in the not only the flowers, the choir, and how many hours did the choir practice, so thank you for all. And finally, if I accomplished some goods in this 15 years of my priesthood, it was not first my merit, but it was which I got really unmerited. Thank you for doing it. Now let us pray. Dear sisters and brothers, gathered around this altar to celebrate the good things we have received from our God, let us ask Him to come in us prayers that are worthy of His hearing.
For Pope Francis, and venerable Archbishop, and honored clergy, to the people today in church, let us pray to the Lord. For wisdom, God knows who are responsible to overcome the corona pandemic in this country. Let us pray to the Lord. God knows to hold with all our faith and limited compassion. Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy,
for authenticity and strong faith, of religious communities in the Philippines and all over the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
And praise to the faithful Father.
For the members of the Salvatorian family worldwide, for the courage and trust to invoke the decision of Blessed Francis Jordan in all their needs. Let us pray to the Lord. For God's blessing to Father Norman and Father Hubert, whose children expected silver anniversary of priesthood, who is a great grateful. Let us pray to the Lord. For in the life to all the beloved deceased of all men present in this holy Eucharist, let us pray to the Lord.
Through the intercession of Blessed Francis Jordan, may these petitions of our unity be pleasing in your sight, merciful Father, so that we may receive from your mercy what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merits. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Okay, brothers and sisters, if my sacrifice is yours, may be acceptable to your divine Father.
May the
Lord
accept the sacrifice for the grace and glory of His name, for our good and for all His holy sinners.
We offer you the sacrifice of praise, O Lord, for the deepening of our service of you, so that what you have conferred on us, unworthy as we are, you may graciously bring to fulfillment. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is to be right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father, most holy, to your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your God, to whom you made all things, whom you sent in as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gathering for you a holy people. This steadfast his hand as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. From the rising to the sun, and into its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we are being thrown by the same spirit, graciously made holy this gift we have brought to you for contemplation, that they may become part of the blood of the Son of the Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate this mystery. On the night he was betrayed, he himself to death, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave you to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. Supper was ended, took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he sent a blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, rather than you, eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you from many for the forgiveness of sins. This is the memory of me.
Sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your Lutheran Church on earth, with your servant Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your people. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout.
To our important brothers and sisters, and to all who for this interview, their passing from this life, give kindness and defense to your kingdom. Let your hope to enjoy my ever to the next of your glory, to look by his tower.
Oh, God, please. Oh,
Almighty Father, in the union of the Holy Spirit, for glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Oh, God.
Your children of God, your people takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord.
Thank you.
Let us pray. For the glory of your name, O Lord, I have joyfully celebrated the mystery of faith to mark the anniversary of my priestly ordination, so that I may keep in truth what I have handled mystically in this sacrifice. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
O God, God bless you. May the Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
May he let his face shine upon you and show you his mercy.
Amen.
May he turn his countenance toward you and give you his grace.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come unto you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Before I say to you peace, you all are heartily invited to our lunch. Go in peace with the Lord.
Yes, with God.
Yeah.